Israelites that are coming up to the truth of their heritage and realize this is their book. This is written about their family. You can easily see it from beginning to end that this is about one people. One people. He's not the God of the Gentiles, the Hudim, the Greek. Christians have done nothing but leech off the heritage of another people. They practice replacement theology and put themselves as the people of the book. Yahweh has a people that he was sent to. And it's the lost sheep of the house of Israel, his firstborn son. That's who Yeshua was sent to.
Let's talk about it, man. Let's talk about this country, man. I'm going to start off by saying that you so-called Negroes and you so-called Latinos and you so-called Native Americans, you are actually the biblical Israelites of the Bible. You didn't learn this in school, right? They told you you were a bunch of so-called black. They told you you were natives. Called you all kind of names like niggas, spigs, all these racist slurs. But that's a big old lie, man. The truth is you're God's chosen people and they don't want you to know that, right? They want you to just be, you know, ignorant to who you are, because, you know, when we do keep God's commandments, we are actually the most powerful people ever. But when we smoke blunts and we don't raise our kids, and when we, you know, become homosexuals and, you know, this, that, and the third, we're not the greatest people on earth. We're a bunch of lost, man. The lost tribes of Israel. That's why Yahawashah came here, for the lost tribes of Israel. Pursuing to Matthew 15 and 24. I'm going to read that right quick before I get started. Matthew chapter 15, verse 24, and it reads, "But he answered," this is Yahawashah speaking, right? This is red letter, right? It says, "But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel," right? This is why Yahawashah came and died on the cross, for you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans who've been enslaved throughout history. You've been mocked and laughed at amongst the other nations, right? You know, and the Bible is our book. It's not a, it doesn't belong to anybody else. All these other nations, you know, have their books, they have their culture, they have their history. And what they failed to tell you is that this book is our heritage and our history, right? Cool. So we can see this chart right here, and we're gonna get right to the chart. But before we get to the chart, you know, we have to give all praise and all glory to the Most High God, right? Who the world calls God, whose name in Paleo Hebrew is Yahweh. It's not Yahweh, it's not Yah, it's not Yahuwah. His name is Yahweh, right? And we give all praise to him. In the name of the only begotten Son, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, right? His name is not Yahshua. His name is Yahawashah, right? Yahawashah Amashiach. That's how you would say Jesus Christ in the Paleo Hebrew. This is Brother Seeley Israel, man. So I'm taking a look at this form here, and underneath ethnicity, they literally have Hispanic and not Hispanic listed. How is this an ethnicity? Hispanic literally means property of Spain. This is sick, man. And this is the country that we live in, man. They try to tell you race doesn't matter. It's not about your race. But then when you go to apply for a job, or you do a refinance or own a home, this is what you're looking at. This is your options. This is what you pick from. This is supposed to be the home of the brave, home of the free. my land is your land. And this is what they have for their so-called demographic form. If there's any Israelites out there that are claiming to bleed red, white, and blue, you're finished, man. If this is the country that you stand for and that you claim to love so much, you're finished. This country was built off of our blood and our labor. Let's get that right quick. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 65 and verse 21. It reads, "In those days, people will live in the homes they build and eat the fruit of their own vineyards." And this prophecy is going into the kingdom of heaven, right? Reading on. "Unlike the past, invaders will not take their homes, Salakia. Invaders will not take their houses and confiscate their vineyards. For my people will live as long as trees, and my chosen ones will have time to enjoy their hard-won gains." Right? The Bible's clear, man. Right? Our land was stolen. We didn't hand it to them. Right? There was no compromise. Right? There was no civil agreement. It was stolen from us, man. Right? They stole the land from the so-called Native Americans, who according to the Bible is the tribe of Gad. They stole the land from them. They stole us from the shores of West Africa, right, where we migrated to from Israel, right? But guess what? The good news is, in the kingdom of heaven, right, we'll actually be living in our homes, and they won't be stolen from us. Let's get Isaiah 14, man. Let's bring out the good news, man, right? Let's bring out the real good news, right? I'm about to sugarcoat it and make you feel good. This is Isaiah 14 and 1. "The Lord will once again be merciful to his people, Israel, and choose them as his own. He will let them live in their own land again, and foreigners will come and live with them. Many nations will help the people of Israel return to the land which the Lord gave them. And there the nations will serve Israel as slaves." That's the good news, man. Imagine in the slave days, people kind of scratching their head trying to figure out what's going on. Why is this happening to us? The good news is, you reap what you sow. Let's get that in Galatians, man. This is Galatians 6 and 7, and it reads, "Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man soweth, that shall he also reap." Right? The Bible's clear, man. You can't enslave a group of people for 500 plus years and kind of sweep it under the rug and kind of call people Hispanic. Call them Native American. What were they called before they were called Native American? Has anybody ever asked that question? Right? Does anybody realize that they spoke Hebrew and they wore fringes? People just go along with whatever Esau tells them. And it's sickening, man. Let's get Revelations. This is the book of Revelations, chapter 12, verse 9. And it reads, "And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan." Got it. So the Bible makes it clear there's a difference between the devil and Satan. Let's go to the book of Revelations, chapter 2, verse 10, and it reads, "Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison." Got it. So the Bible lets us know that whoever the devil is, he casts people into prison. And the last time I checked, right? Matter of fact, the last time I was pulled over, by an Edomite police officer who could have potentially, if he wanted to, he has the gun, you know, he has his backup, could have potentially taken me to prison. So the Bible lets me know who the devil is. Let's go back to Revelation chapter 12 and 9, right? And let's read it one more time from the top. "And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world." They deceived the whole world, man. This is why you're calling yourself Hispanic, you know, Native American, Black. Where is the land of Black? Could somebody please tell me, you know, where the land of Black is so I can hop on the plane and visit the land of Black? It's not a real thing. Everything that Esau has told us is a bunch of crap, man. And it's sickening. Let's go to the book of Psalms. This is Psalms chapter 49, verse 11. And it reads, "Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever," right? And this passage here is going into the Edomites, man, right? Because if you ask any Edomite who's a part of the United States of America, you might tap one on the shoulder and say, "Hey, what do you think the fate of this country is?" And you know what they'll tell you? "Everything is going to be fine. The pandemic will end soon." There's not going to be a war. And that's what they really think, man. The Bible's clear. According to 2 Esdras 15 and 15, World War III is on its way, man. It's not a game. It's not a joke. It's not a maybe. Maybe it'll happen. Maybe it won't happen. It's going to happen, man. Reading on. "And their dwelling places to all generations. They call their lands after their own names." Right? Last time I checked, Africa was named after an Edomite named Scipio Africanus, right? Last time I checked, America was named after another Edomite named Amurgo Vespucci. And I'm probably pronouncing his name wrong, but I don't care, man. We're not dealing with Edomites, man. I say all this to say that this chart is a reflection of this country. And this country is a reflection of deception. The Bible tells us that the devil deceived the whole world. The Bible tells us that the devil throws us into prisons. Right? Let's connect the dots here. This is the book of Habakkuk, chapter 2, verse 18, and it reads, "What's the use of an idol? It is only something that a human being has made, and it tells you nothing but lies," right? What idol was set up in this country, right? The most famous individual ever to live, his name was Mashiach Yehoshua, right? They later changed his name to Jesus Christ, right? Not only did they change his name, right? They changed the way the man looked, right? According to Revelation chapter 1, verse 14, the Messiah has woolly hair, right? According to Daniel chapter 7, verse 9, right? his father, the Most High God, also has woolly hair. So why are we seeing an image of a man with dog stringy hair and pale skin? Once again, Revelation tells us that the devil deceived the whole world. The book of Habakkuk lets us know that idols tell nothing but lies. Reading on. What good does it do for its maker to trust it? A God that can't even talk. I wanted this video to be short and sweet today, man. To get the point across that our enemy has done nothing but try to keep us ignorant, try to keep us in a dumb state. They want us to do nothing but make rap songs and smoke weed. But the Bible tells us that we're God's chosen people, and we're a special people unto the Lord. Brother C. Lee Israel, man. I love the Father, I love the Messiah, and I love my people. And I can't wait for the day that this place is back to normal, and we're back on top, and we're keeping the commandments, and we're serving our God with truth and sincerity. Shalom to the 12 tribes of Israel scattered abroad. Brother C. Lee Israel, Kwame Asharala, Shalom.